All right, Losers Finals is beginning. Capricious versus Kshatriya on Vitra. The map, that is the players, starting up. Get this thing going, and that will be it. So this is the Losers Finals, which means, of course, that there is still one more game. One more series after this for the Grand Finals, possibly two, depending on who wins the Grand Finals. But yeah, Capricious vs. Kshatriya for the chance to fight against Failthus to possibly take the tournament. Although Failthus has an easy ride here because Failthus just has to win one series afterwards, whereas Capricious or Kshatriya, whoever wins this, needs to win two against Failthus. And Failthus is as scary as ever. So, certainly going to be a tricky challenge.
Indeed.
And Vitra as a map itself, I mean, Capricious, we've seen them work better when they have some room to build up and harass around. So, this map's good for harassment. Not sure if it's as good for building up in a safe way, because it's pretty open. Just doesn't seem likely to me that it's something that would allow for that easily. Capricious going for Kalukubot Factory. Kshatriya, on the other hand, Kshatriya we've also seen is a very micro-heavy player, but they can expand well. So I feel like we're seeing a lot of similar styles here, like tricky players that have a macro game. I'm kind of curious, we'll find out now, who has a stronger macro game with tricks. Because that's what it's going to come down to.
Here we go.
So, Kalukubot versus thing. Jumpbot! Oh, of course, why am I even asking? So, Kshatriya with the Jumpbot Factory. Kalukubot for Capricious. I mean, we saw this in the last, I believe it was the last Swiss round. Or no, it wasn't the last Swiss round, it was the first. It was the winner semifinals. Yeah, so back to this match. I mean, the players do know each other. They're quite familiar with how they're playing now. Kshatriya still in the Jumpbot Factory. Capricious still in the Kalukubot Factory. Not surprised, no vehicles, even though vehicles work well, we've established. I wonder what Kshatriya's feeling right now. I mean, they're probably feeling kind of underconfident. They did just lose 2-0. I mean, to Capricious. Because Capricious knocked them into the losers bracket.
I'm not sure if they mind. I don't know them personally or what their character is. If they get set up upset about a win or a loss,
I don't know. Just thinking because this is the person that knocked them into losers. Like, you know, they went 2-0. It wasn't even a match. Just thinking, are they thinking I'm going to try to go for some tricks? Because right now they seem to be playing the same way they have always been playing. They're not looking like they're going for any tricks or any odd play that would give them an advantage that they hadn't had already. But they're also starting on a larger map. Because, I mean, the first map was like Altair crossing into Iced Coffee.
I think, in general, you're better off with defenders here.
Against Clokies, yeah. Especially against Blaze.
Yeah, especially
Blaze,
against Clokies.
Yeah, I find
Lotus
Lotuses
in general.
I don't know. Lotuses, I think, work really well against Bandits. And work well against things like Scorchers. I mean, as well as you can against a Scorcher, but stuff that requires a bit more damage. Also against Pyros, they work really well because defenders just don't kill it in time. Against Glaives, they're great.
Neither
though.
Does a Lotus.
Against a Pyro? That's pretty close.
No, Pyro kills a
yeah,
one Lotus.
Barely. That's true. But I mean, if you have to pick one. At any rate, Kshatriya, I mean, now they're on a larger map, so I think that Kshatriya might actually be a bit more comfortable because, like I said before, the two maps they played against Kshatriya on, sorry, they played Capricious on, were tiny. Like, Altair Crossing is a tiny reclaim-heavy map, and Iced Coffee, while they played it a bit more of a macro game, is still a tiny map that any mistaken play will just cause a lot of problems. Vitra's a bit more forgiving and bigger.
Oh boy, that's a nice It's hiding behind the metal extractor.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I figured that would happen. One metal extractor death is a bit of a problem, but it was going to die to the Lotus afterwards.
Yeah, it's an equal trade.
Yeah,
reclaim and...
I don't know.
But yeah, the Capricious is moving forward with his constructor, already making a turret on Xatria's side of the map. It has even a warrior there too.
Yeah. Oh, that pyro. I mean, Capricious really on point with the weapon choices. Whether a machine gun or lightning gun has always been the right choice. I mean, that's against Jumpbot. Of course, you're going to go for the lightning gun. We mentioned before. That's how you do it. So this is probably going to be... I'm guessing Shaz is going to have to do a factory switch, or is going to have to go for heavier moderator firewalker play. And they're going to have to use the rest of the Jumpbot factory. Because right now, it is just impossible. Like, there's nothing they can really do with pyros that's going to be able to penetrate anything that Capricious has set up. I mean, Kshatriya could build up and get their economy going, just not worry about raiding Capricious too much. Just go around, just build up. Get a larger army. Capricious isn't going for anything big or raidery.
Nope.
It's just any raiding options. And Kshatriya, I think, is so focused. They seem so fixated on raiding. I don't know, I don't see a lot of construction. I mean, there's the one freaker. There's still more pyros. Yeah, they seem very focused.
The classic one warrior attack, but it failed.
Classic one warrior suicide?
On flat ground, it actually works. But if you have to move uphill, it doesn't.
Yeah, that's true. But that's also true about the hill. So yeah, Capricious not really doing too hot. Capricious is doing okay. Kshatriya is not doing too hot, but still okay. Okay, another freaker. Good. They finally got another freaker. Not Freaker, it's Constable. It's the one name I keep forgetting has changed. Constable. They got an extra Constable, which is exactly what they need.
Constructor, okay.
Yeah. They got renamed recently. But anyway, yeah, so they got another
Capricious
Constructor.
Capricious needs more Constructors too. He's...
There's three of them. No, four of them.
He can afford it.
Yeah, two of them are basically idle, free caretakers, and the other two are actually expanding. Although
the first turrets in the center were nice, but now he's a bit overdoing it.
Yeah, especially given their proximity to each other, one firewalker kills them.
Yeah.
Like, Kshatriya is playing the factory that can deal with that most easily. So I'm not quite
apart
sure what the motivation
shields.
Shields, really? I mean, I guess Racketeer, but Racketeer
fell in. A couple of thugs and a couple of bandits, and you just move in from...
Oh, yeah, that's true.
From,
that's a fair point.
From the head of the line, not straight like this.
Yeah, I know what you mean. Like, take it from the side. The one thing, though, is that with the... I'm saying for jump bots, though, is because jump bots have... What do they have? Jump bots have the single unit that does it. Like, shields, you're right. They do a good job, but it's just, it requires unit synergy. Whereas with jump bots, it's just build a firewalker and burn it down. Which is exactly what Kshatriya is doing. So we actually see a firewalker from Kshatriya.
It's a 900 metal unit. Huh.
Oh yeah, they're expensive. They actually got made cheaper recently. I think they were 1500
exactly. Before. I thought they were 1500.
They were 1500. They got buffed recently.
Oh.
It was a couple months ago they got buffed. There's been a lot of gradual work making the Jumpbot factory more and more viable in regular play.
No. Pyros are not to be traded like that. I'm not for trading. Not.
Yeah, that Lotus is not going to die. Especially with their caretaker repairing. Even without the caretaker, it would have lived at like 200 health.
Always, if you're doing raids, raiding in general, always raid the locations that
Firewalker.
Are the furthest, the most far away from the enemy's factory as you can.
Yes.
Always the weakest spot.
Yeah, the defender's advantage is the least there.
You're less likely to run into turrets because there's been less time for turrets to be built there. You never use your pyros for front or straight up attack. Not very late into the game or when you know for sure that he has no turrets there.
Yeah. One thing I'm curious about is Capricious knows about the turrets in the front. They know they're there. They're going to take care of them. They don't know about the size, though.
Lone warrior attack number two. This time is fine.
Hey. Yeah, it actually worked this time. The firewalker's doing its job somewhat, but that's not really important right now because that center area is not that much of a threat, actually. Like, taking care of it's easy, but at the same time, What is it blocking? What is it defending? I guess the direct pass.
Ah, but now the firework might get sniped. It's a really, really nice attack. That's exactly where Siths are good for.
And two more scythes coming in. Capricious, still relentless on the scythe pressure, as
the
before.
Warrior in the back of the base, it's still there. Should move a bit.
Yeah, it should, but it's actually right inside the fire cloud. Problem is the moderators, but yeah, it's like... okay, now it's getting hit. And Kshatriya versus Capricious Commander. Kshatriya's Commander being stunned out, though. Needs to jump, get out of there! No, it's dead.
Boom. Wow. Yeah, that's it.
And Capricious takes game one. Oh,
1-0.
It's like a repeat of the Altair Crossing game in the winter semifinals, where it's just Capricious comes in with relentless scythes and then just forces Kshatriya into a corner. Except in that case, Kshatriya started in a corner. This time, Kshatriya just had nowhere really to go, got contained. I guess that was the point of the defenses, was more so that the direct path was not available, and then there was a staging point that Capricious had that Kshatriya couldn't easily deal with. So yeah, that's game one. Moving on to game two, which will be on Kshatriya's choice of map. Not really sure what Kshatriya's gonna go for though, because last time they went for iced coffee and it backfired. I mean, of the choices of maps they have, I mean, Bandit Plains worked out well that one time, but against Capricious, that would be an even match. Could still work, though. All right. To see what Kshatriya has for their map choice, and then when we have that, we are moving on to game two. And then afterwards, oh boy. I mean, at this point, Capricious is on track to fight up against Phaelthas again. And there's not much more to be said. I mean, Capricious basically, if they win this next match, they have to fight Phaelthas and beat Phaelthas in two series.
Yeah.
Quite honestly, the way this has been going, I wouldn't be surprised if Capricious won this and then lost to Phaelthas. It seems like there's been a very clear...
ranking.
Yeah, ranking, that's the word. Thank you. My addiction starts to fail when I've been up this late, but yeah, there's a clear rank difference.
Yeah, it's Phaelthas, Capricious, Kshatriya.
Wait, why the heck? Two.
Oh, Kshatriya is going for hide and seek now.
Why isn't it letting... whatever. Yeah, I can actually change this. No, I don't really have a match. So yeah, Phaelthas... I mean, Phaelthas and Capricious was closer than Capricious and Kshatriya last time. That's the one thing. Billy, hide and seek! I mean, I guess they saw the match with Capricious and Phaelthas and realized that Capricious doesn't really know hide and seek very well at all.
But they listened in on your stream.
Yeah, they're. I'm pretty sure everyone's been watching the stream. Yeah, Kshatriya's on Twitch. Actually, Kshatriya's on Twitch right now.
Ah, okay.
I mean, like I said, the stream is delayed, so it's not like it's totally terrible, but please don't. But yeah, they've been watching the stream. They've been watching it at least when they haven't been playing. I can't speak for when they have been playing, but when they haven't been playing, they have been watching the stream. And they know. And I agree with their choice. Of course, the question is, while it's clear that Kshatriya wasn't super familiar with this map and wasn't sure what to do with it, is Kshatriya familiar enough with this map that they do?
I have no idea.
Nor do I. But I want to find out, so let's find out. Kshatriya is... more familiar with the map. Slightly. Last played it 10 months ago and has played it 5 times. Really? Oh yeah, those stats are accurate. Okay, wow. Actually, heck, I've only played it 6 months ago. Yeah, I've only played it 7 times. Last time, 6 months ago. So, I guess there's a thing. I've watched a lot of maps in this, or watched a lot of games in this map.
I'm not sure if I, how much I played in Zero K.
Yeah, I think... Well, actually, we can find out. This is a really cool tool. Although, fortunately, let's actually get to the game itself.
That's much more interesting.
Yeah, it's much more interesting than map stats. Map stats are kind of boring. Kshatriya is going down for Clokibot Factory. Kshatriya's doing that. Capricious hasn't chosen their particular factory yet. And you've played it 4 times as XIV Floris.
Oh, of course, yeah, you need to take into account my 50 million smurfs.
I am. Anyway. Oh, with your other smurfs, 10 times total. Anyway, the match started. Capricious going for Spiderbot Factory again. Spider versus Clokey for Kshatriya this time, rather than Failthas. And Kshatriya going for an early Scythe. Which kind of makes sense in this map. Early Scythe and a couple early Glaives. Very expensive, though. That had better basically get rid of Capricious's base. Or get rid of the 2.4 Metal Extractor over and over and over again. One of the two. Kshatriya also building another 2.4. Which, you know, I'm starting to think might not actually be a great idea. At least if you're not going to build an early Constructor. Because, yeah, you get an extra Metal Extractor for the cost of one. But you're that much further away from the other metal extractors. Right now, Capricious has a metal advantage, and actually has for the entire game. Pretty much.
All those 55 seconds, yeah. Except for the first 15 or so.
Yeah, so basically Capricious has about 45 metal ahead.
It's splitting hairs.
It is splitting hairs, but the thing is, if you're going to be jumping for the 2.4 metal extractor... I mean, at this point, splitting hairs matters, though. I mean, okay, 60 metal isn't a big deal. That's basically one glaive. Like, Kshatriya has one fewer glaive than they could have had. That's the difference. Or maybe not, because they actually...
Only...
I know, no, never mind. No, because that's the cost of the metal extractor. Yeah. If they had done the 2.4 and then one of the 1.3s, then yes, they would have had an extra glaive.
That constructor may or may not die.
It's... They're actually very much at risk. That Venom's out of range.
Yeah, turrets are your friend.
Oh, that Venom's just in range, but didn't matter. Did not matter. The Scythe is dead. That's not the most efficient. I mean, it wasn't bad, but that's not the most efficient way of doing it.
Oh, wow. A Venom can permastun.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, it can. It really can.
I thought there was always this fraction of a second in between... Paralyzed.
Depends on the unit.
Next shot.
Depends on what's getting paralyzed. Anyway, with that happening, though, Kshatriya is expanding in the back. They do have an expansion behind it, which is good. Like, they want to have an expansion behind their rating. We've seen it too many times that people rating such expansion.
Yeah. But that's one of the bigger ones. It's 2.5.
Yep. Kshatriya seems to be aware of it, though. And harassing... And Kshatriya is really scouting around the map. I like that. They're really just exploring around. Taking the... Hey! Southeast corner is being taken. I don't recall that being taken in any of the games we've seen on this map. Well, in the last game, it wasn't taken.
Southeast.
Northwest might have been.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, maybe. Last game, it was taken.
The Northwest was. I don't think the Southeast
Failed was. Failed was rushing it.
Oh, really? Oh, wow. Okay, thanks, Stanford. Yeah, I wasn't sure. Feldhaus took everything, and it's like... Yeah, I guess they would have taken that, too.
But he's moving up the hill in the other corners, yes. The bottom right.
Yeah, the southeast is being taken by Kshatriya, the northwest is
unclaimed.
That's a long
walk. But those are bigger maxes, I guess, yeah. The thing is, that hill is reachable by regular bots, too. It's not...
Yeah, it is, and the thing with that hill, though, is that Capricious has set up a few fleas trying to scout around. But Kshatriya has already gone over there before the fleas got there.
Yeah.
And Glaive attacks too, and only flees there. I mean, some venoms, but only flees. The Spiderbot factory not building anything. Kshatriya getting rid of a bunch of fleas, as long as they make sure to escape. Like, don't go back.
At least they made cost in fleas.
Yes, but just don't go back. Don't deal with the venoms. They're going to kill you. And that's exactly what Kshatriya's doing. Kshatriya's really tactically playing it well. And hey, they got the 2.5 metal extractor right there for free. If Kshatriya realizes this, goes to the 2.5 metal extractor, that'll be golden. Because then, at this point, Kshatriya's already ahead economically.
Yeah, he is.
Like, they're taking all the corners, taking all the heavy, and yeah, they got it too. So they're taking all the great metal extractors, and they're denying Capricious's own metal extractors. Ah, the redback's done though. That's death.
Nice timing.
That is perfect timing. I mean, some stuff was lost, but still, for the comeback, right, for those Glaives getting back in the base, that redback, that was... I mean, it would have been pretty close regardless, because, I mean, the Glaives would have dealt some damage, it had some leeway. But yes, that was still the best timing possible.
This is such a sneaky expansion, it's almost cheesy.
Oh yeah, I love doing this sort of thing. Intersection's the best map for this, but Hide and Seek's also really good for that. Actually, Hide and Seek might be a better map for that.
On Intersection, it's a bit obvious.
Yeah, that's true. Intersection's the worst map for that, come to think of it. Hide and Seek's actually really good for this. Yeah, Intersection is kind of the thing you just do. You always go for Ninja Expansion.
Also nice overdrive, it's high up.
Oh, the wind gens?
Yeah, it's good winter bonus.
Holy crap.
1 to 2.5.
1 to 2.5 is the highest this map goes for all the height difference it has? Wow. Must be not very windy map.
All about height difference, isn't it?
Yeah, but some maps at this height would be like 2. I don't know if it necessarily is height difference or absolute height. Like, it might be absolute elevation. So if there's a really low sea level on a map like Ravage, for instance, you get... Actually, Ravage is kind of crappy, too. I think there's a map wind parameter that determines just how much the height bonus is going to be.
Oh, I thought that was not part of the 0k.
I don't know. I haven't actually really tested against elevation that closely. Because the actual elevation, the raw elevation number. Still, 1 to 2.5 is a great win bonus. That's still fine.
Yeah.
That still makes them far more worth than
this. For Sifs.
Oh my goodness, there's nothing in the base.
Oh, it's one shot. They just one shot a.
One shot the Lotus, and there's nothing else to block it. The only thing is the Venom. The Venom will permastun everything, it'll stunlock everything. They've got to get those sides split up. Kshatriya, just split up those sides. Actually, just get out of there. That's the better option. That was a really good attack, though.
That's a lot of Lotuses. Oh boy.
Yeah, that's a bit harder to deal with. The main base attack was great though, got rid of two Weavers for free.
LT overpowered. Lotus overpowered.
Capricious Commander in a bit of a bind.
Those Lotuses just killed three Zeus's.
Yeah. And now Kshatriya way ahead economically, just keeping Capricious down. Like, Kshatriya is basically playing this the same way, or not the same way, but a similar way that Failthas did. Much sneakier though, Failthas was much more direct. But still, the general idea of keep the pressure on, keep Capricious from building up too much, especially these really valuable expansions. Same general strategy, just different approach.
Oh boy, he's going for the second round two.
Oh, well, that's actually not going to be a bad idea. Another Weaver dead.
LTs. No, he just...
Okay, now they've got to leave. They got to get out of there. I mean, Capricious, there. There's the
he
shot.
He can afford the losses. Sorry, I was talking about the different part of the map.
Yeah, he's you're talking about down here with the Zeus, aren't you?
Yeah. He just lost four Zeuses and two Warriors to a bunch of turrets.
Yeah, but at the same time, the Scythes are getting rid of a bunch of Weavers. And actually getting rid of the Venom, too.
What?
Venom down, Redback is still a threat.
It is.
The Scythes need to recloak. My goodness, this entire base is going down. Everything's going down. The Weaver's down as well. I think this is game.
Get out of it.
Oh no, Kshatriya, what are you doing? You're not paying attention to the critical moment. Just get rid of that factory. Factory's down. Get those scythes out of there. Factory down. Capricious rebuilding with a caretaker south here. Just like, Proxy Factory is the only option that Christus has right now. Or it's the only one that they're considering. They aren't terrible for options right now. I mean, they have a lot of metal in storage. They're excessing, actually. So they can build up some stuff really quick. But no, it looks like they're going to be going for... What are they going for? Terraforming for what? Building a factory of some kind. Are they going for a they're going for a vehicle factory.
Wow.
Well, tanks, specifically, but yeah.
Hell, why not?
I guess.
Why? Yeah, let's just do it. What is he going to build?
I have no idea. Against what they're dealing with, I wouldn't even go for tanks in the first place. I'd go for light vehicles if you're going to go for vehicles and just spam darts for sides, but... Failing that, I guess...
I think he would have been better off with a Strider hub.
Yeah, just a tank through anything.
And make a Dante? Because
pretty much.
What are... Panthers? No. Why Panthers?
I think Capricious might be locked in a mindset. I think they might be thinking of something very specific, like maybe the light vehicle matchup, or just if I find anything, I'll stun it out and it's no problem, even though Kshatriya has a massive army advantage.
Actually, if he would have morphed that commander with two more nanolate modules, and he would have spent 600 medals in defenders and lotuses. Can you imagine? Towards his base?
Yeah. Yeah, as opposed to the factory, which I don't know what it's going to do. The best thing the Panther can do right now is honestly to die.
Yeah.
Which actually didn't really manage
to buy some defenders.
What?! Well, yeah. Okay. That... Wow. Talk about irony. All those defenses.
I think 10 lotuses, or maybe 5 lotuses and 5 defenders.
Yeah.
Crawl forwards. I think you're better off that way.
Yeah, it would have definitely meant less retreating into your own defender line of fire to get blown up.
So it's 1-1?
Yeah, it's 1-1. Yeah, that was... I mean, a bit of an embarrassing way to lose, but the thought was definitely 1-1, because Kshatriya picked the right map. Like, was that ever the right map? I just feel like that was such a comical way of ending it. It's like, okay, you're just gonna...
Let's build a tank factory in your face.
Build a tank factory in my face. Oh shit, my defenders are turning against me! Voiced by his own petard. Yeah, that was bad. I'm sorry, I don't mean to be trash-talking, but, like, that was... That happened.
That trio one.
That was pretty fun to watch, though. That was a very entertaining game.
It was
just a really weird ending. Which is why it was entertaining. Because it ended really off. I was like, what the heck was going on? Yeah. Alright, so, Capricious gets the final choice of map. I wonder what's gonna pick. I mean, it's pretty clear that if the map isn't very hilly, Kshatriya has a harder time. Well, okay. Logical
Red
conclusion.
Comets.
Red Comet.
My money's in Capricious again.
Yeah, me too. I mean, there's not much to be said about that. That's basically the flattest map you can find. It's a
one-off.
I still think that's a bit of a gamble, but yeah, I do agree that Capricious has a stronger time here.
He seems to be pretty good at the tank and vehicle game. In general,
yeah.
He's good with all the classic, the old factories, the bulky vehicles and tanks.
He's
and
a much
not so
older
much
player.
All the new stuff and the funky 0k stuff.
Well, he's a newer player, and Kshatriya is much more of a 0k player.
Capricious, maybe I'm confusing two players. You have Capricious and Capricious.
Oh,
those
maybe. Those
are maybe two different players, huh? I will look it up.
I don't know. Capricious looks like they're pretty old player. And I was looking them up, and yeah, they're 5 years ago. That was when they first got here. And I'm pretty sure that's actually when 0k as a separate game happened. They're probably older than that.
No, according to Spring, it's the same guy.
Yeah, that's what I thought, because Like, 5 years ago was when 0k.info, I think, was made. So any accounts that are 5 years old are probably much older than 5 years old. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm fairly certain that is the age. Anyway, Red Comet.
Here we go.
Capricious going for tanks. I mean, they really want to play tanks. It was very clear from the last game. And Kshatriya yet to choose. Okay, there we go. Hovercraft. Have not seen that this tournament yet.
No, and now you will beat everyone with hovercrafts from here on.
Yeah, let's see. Kshatriya, make them hovercrafts count. Ooh, right off the bat with scalpels.
Not even going to try to be subtle.
Nope. Not going for the daggers, not going for the tricks. Well, yeah, not going for the tricks. Just going for straightforward damage. Scalpel and Quill against Kodachis, which are going to be just... Yeah, it's going to be tricky, but I think...
It's like the Skirmish Riot unit.
Yeah. I think scalpels have a decent chance if there's enough of them. But I think there'll only be two at most by the time the Kodachi first makes it there. So that's going to be tricky. Even...
The thing is, with scalpels, do they still have homing missiles?
They do, but they don't home super well. Okay. They got nerfed a bit.
I think they should just be dumpfire.
I think that might nerf them a bit too much. Especially since that also overlaps a bit with the Recluse.
Hmm. Doesn't make sense.
Oh boy. That's one. Apparently,
yeah, no,
well,
just
it's two
get
shots.
Away.
That's good enough. Kshatriya just needs to buy time. I mean, if they're going for a very heavy scalpel build, all they need to do is buy time to be able to
Until
build up their force push. Yeah, build up like five or six of them and then just push. They're not going for daggers. They're not trying to overwhelm early on. They're not going for a raider game.
No, and if you're not going for a raider game, you can expand harder.
Yeah. Well, kind of. I mean, you have to be a bit more careful because you don't have your raiders to defend. But yeah.
I didn't make a second scalpel.
Oh, that Quill is so close. It's like one health away. Okay, finally done. You can start building up some metal extractors. But yeah, the Kodachi is pretty well kept at bay. Yeah. And Kshatriya with some good radar coverage, so they know exactly what's going on. Capricious, however, with a Panther, that'll probably give them the confidence to move the Kodachi forward. And the Kodachi's very nearly healed up. So it's going to be another couple scalpel shots, and the scalpel, however, does
Kshatriya
not have automatic healing.
On 9 metal, Capricious is on 21, but
oh,
neither
man.
Have the energy. At least, well, Capricious has not enough energy.
Yeah,
and
but
he
still...
just spams down...
What the heck are you doing, Kshatriya? Build more metal extractors! Kshatriya's just pushing so much into the factory
right
now.
It's nice that scalpel rush, but it has to be shooting to be worth it.
And it's going
to
die very shortly. Like, that scalpel's got one shot, and it's dead.
Yeah, it's dead now. Fix double the pricing, double the cost in raiders, but it's dead.
Yeah. Well, it's also a skirmisher, so the raiders deal with it to begin with. And finally, we see some daggers up here. I mean...
No, that's the thing with scalpels. It's a riot skirmisher.
Yeah, I don't know. It's not bad for riot because of splash, but against tanks? I don't know. I feel like it's a riot skirmisher to deal with ducks more than a riot skirmisher to deal with vehicles or tanks. Maybe scorchers. Sheesh. I think Kshatriya has just got to really focus on their expansion. Capricious is so far ahead economically. I mean, this is exactly what Capricious was hoping for.
Yeah.
Was that... Because I thought Kshatriya would build one or two scalpels, use them to defend a growing expansion base. Not build a massive scalpel rush and focus all their metal into that, leave themselves behind. At this point, Kshatriya needs to destroy, like... About all of Capricious's metal extractors, I think. Somewhere around all... Maybe a little less than all of them, but very nearly all of them, in order to be able to make cost and get back here.
Yeah.
Are you smashing your keyboard?
No, I was closing a bag of crisps.
Oh, yeah, you're really close to your mic when you do that.
Yeah, it's an annoying noise, I know.
Sorry, well, then don't do it near the microphone. Okay, 3 should be enough.
It is.
Yeah, now the scalpels have a bit of a chance of getting back in this. Like, now at this point... Although, Capricious going for Amphib. Going for the Grizzly straight up. I mean, they can. They've got 30 metal per second. Why not? It's a good idea.
30 metal per second? Well, it still takes 30 seconds to build it.
True, but by the time that happens, that'll be when the scalpels arrive.
Now he needs to make sure that the scalpels don't find the amphib factory.
Oof. I don't know. Oh, it's a minute yet. Still a minute, and the scalpels are exactly on the way to the amphib factory.
He could just lose this because of this. All his
if Kshatriya moves forward, all Kshatriya, Kshatriya just needs to move forward and it's done. Oh, this halberd, it's halberd micro. That is what's going to win the game. Oh, and they're too close.
He's morphing his commander, which is, he's going to level 3 now. Wow.
Ooh, that worked okay. The defender kind of saved it, but the lack of scalpels is probably going to do it in. I don't think Kshatriya's even going to try to move in. And Capricious,
he's spending all his resources on the
oh no, the halberd's going in. Now. It's scouting.
Yeah.
And it missed it. It just missed it. Ah, Kshatriya has no idea that Capricious is building this.
He doesn't?
Unless they're stream sniping. But yeah.
Wow.
Close. Oh, I mean, at the same time, though, Kshatriya has been building up, so it's not all bad. I mean, the Grizzly's going to be a pain in the ass, but scalpels are still the counter to begin with, or at least a good counter. Scalpels and halberds, I would say, would be the thing to do. So it's not bad.
I think penetrators are the thing to do now.
Oh, yeah, that's a good point. The penetrators do exist. But up comes the Grizzly. I mean, Capricious, they're continuing to build up, but yeah, it's like Kshatriya at least has been expanding.
Yeah.
But this is going to be a tough fight.
Start spamming daggers.
He
didn't defend, he just naked expanded everywhere.
Well, now the Grizzly is known, so let's see what the response is.
Yeah, let's build. He's even building a Goliath now.
Oh, man. I guess Goliath they expect penetrators.
And Grizzly.
And the right two. Penetrator is coming up. Did I put a delay on the stream, right? Like, I did put it. Yeah, it's the tournament mode. It should be delayed. Yeah, apparently it's a 2-minute delay. Okay, Capricious Kshatriya knows what to do. It just so happens that they also know you also know what to do, so it all works out.
I think that's Dein Freund.
Dein Freund, mute yourself, please. I don't mind people listening in on Mumble. Just make sure you're muted. I shall locally mute them anyway. Alright, so yeah, this is pretty good, actually. I gotta say, Kshatriya's doing a pretty good job of harassing here.
Grizzly chasing a commander.
Yeah, so Grizzly's chasing the commander. I mean, as soon as the vision comes in, the commander's gonna take a fair amount of damage. Not gonna die. It's gonna take some damage. But the thing is, that Grizzly's on the way. Kshatriya has full radar coverage. The penetrator is halfway to getting close enough to hit the thing. Oops.
Well, having that penetrator alone is not enough. Grizzly can
still you're right. It's only 1,000 damage. But still. Or I think it's 1,000. Maybe 2,000. 3,000! Wow, I was way off. But yeah, you need 3 shots to kill the Grizzly. But still, there's the halberds on top of that. And the penetrator. There it goes! And it misses! How long does it take to reload? 20 seconds. Okay, so it takes a minute to kill a Grizzly. But that doesn't matter. That's honestly a distraction. You know what the real story is? Scalpels! In the eastern side of the map, killing everything.
Yeah, but hey, just in time delivery of Mike Alive will stop the.
What is with these just in time deliveries? Weird. Everyone, or Conversions at least, has been just so on point with these.
Yeah, let's. Who has the bigger range? It's fairly similar, right?
The Goliath and the Scalpel? The advantage is. No, it's equal. Yeah, you're right. Yeah, wow, exactly. And Goliath's projectile, I believe, is faster. No, Goliath's projectile is slower. It just has better splash damage. So if the scalpels move, then they can get out of the way and the homing works, but they just die instead.
Oh, that commander is playing so risky with 2 penetrators there.
Yeah. Oh, and that Grizzly is... Oh, no, they're not focus firing! Focus your fire penetrators. You only have so much. They focus fire on either of the grizzlies. Actually, it won't be death. The halberds need to deal some damage first.
It's time to build another cloaky lab.
Yeah. Get a sniper out there. Or a specter, rather. There we go. One grizzly down.
That's what penetrators are for.
But unfortunately, Kshatriya, look at their economy now. After that great story of scalpels blowing stuff up, what is there? There's nothing.
Grizzly, a Goliath, and another Goliath. Oh no, that's a Reaper.
Yeah.
So many big units. This is so funny.
But hey, at the same time, at least some damage is being dealt, I guess?
I guess. Yeah, shoot that stupid penetrator!
Man, all the demi-striders. How much health? Oh, 12,000. Okay, that's why. I'm thinking, how much health does that Goliath have? Oh, a ridiculous amount. That's how much.
And that's why they're 2,200. Okay.
Sheesh. I mean, so, the more and more penetrators that come out.
Three penetrators against two grizzlies and a Goliath.
Well,
it's
three
time
penetrators.
For glaives again.
Four penetrators, or actually. Ducks. No, three. Yeah. Just three. But still, three penetrators, they do one shot a grizzly. So.
Yeah, they do.
Well, potentially.
Do they? No, four. Then you need four. No, three.
Yeah, you need three. The thing is that you need to actually hit the grizzly perfectly all the time.
No, I think you. Don't you immediately regenerate a portion of your HP after the first hit? So you always end up with 0 point something hit
though.
Points?
It needs to be simultaneous.
Yeah.
Also, I don't think grizzlies have in-combat regen.
Oh, maybe.
At any rate, Kshatriya does have a fair amount of reclaim to work with, so there's that.
Jeez.
Just needs to hurry up with that reclaim. Holy crap, this is not good. Get that
three
will
bases.
Out
That's
of there.
Exactly what he needed. Now, focus that that mace.
Oh, man. Well, that's one penetrator, or one light, lightning, one panther down. Penetrators are going down. Oh, man, this is tough. Kshatriya's command with machine gun doing a bit of damage, but unfortunately, one penetrator down, two penetrators down, a third penetrator going
to
fall.
One about to go. And now it's grizzlies again.
Yeah, and the grizzlies
without
now have a massive advantage.
That's not a fair fight.
This is
yeah,
it.
GG.
Oh man.
Nice.
I thought Kshatriya had a chance. And Kshatriya had a chance there. It's just move that one little bit forward to see the grizzly just that little bit in advance. Oh man, that was close. I mean, it fell apart at the end, but right at that one point, it was like Kshatriya could have just completely wrecked Capricious's investments at that point. And break the factory, break the entire area, grizzlies down, there's no more grizzlies being produced. And then, that was so close. If they hadn't lost those scalpels, it would have been even better. How much metal excess was there anyway? Wow, Kshatriya accessed a lot of metal. Oh, okay. Kshatriya actually accessed about a penetrator's worth of metal. Penetrator, almost two penetrators worth of metal. Or a penetrator and a couple of maces. That's not good. That would have actually turned things around. That much firepower.
I don't know.
I think
nobody raided. Everybody was just making one unit.
That's true. That's actually a good point. There wasn't a lot of death going on for the first, 3 minutes of the game. And it's like one or two units killed. Also. Yeah, it only got about 9 or 10 units killed at about 7 minutes into the game.
Really small units are good.
Sheesh. That was a very different game. But anyway, congratulations, Capricious. You're on to fighting Feltas again. And Kshatriya, congratulations on third place. So we are moving on to the winners. So the grand finals. The absolute grand finals. Quite possibly
Feltas
the last match.
Up.
Feltas is indeed up. Grand finals. I don't know what the map is going to be. Grand finals on... A map. I don't know. Well, Grand Finals 1. We'll see if there's another one needed, but yes, definitely the first Grand Finals. It's on a map. It's a map that exists. All right, are we gonna have stuff here? I need to know what the map is before I can do the whole intro stuff and everything. And say, this is the map. But man, I'm sure Kshatch is going to be kind of salty when they see the replay and go, oh my goodness, that was so close!
Maybe.
Maybe, I don't know. If they're like me, they'd get pretty salty about it, but then I get salty about everything, so it's not exactly saying much. Anyone who's watched my Skullcrawl stuff knows just how salty I get. Or my 0K stuff. Alright, are we getting thing? Alright, what is the map? The map is... This is not really good anticipation music, but oh well. Come on, Varzival. Write it down, darn it. Obsidian. All right.
Oh, hey.
Hey, nice to see Obsidian.